Hello viewers, on behalf of BNCM Study Festivity, I am Dr. Pranav Kumar Chakravarti. Today, my deliberation is on the subject accounting. This is the class number 10 class in the phase 3 of accounting, where we are carrying with the topic partnership accounting. Partnership accounting, good number of issues have already been discussed, and at present we are focusing on the topic, that is valuation of goodwill. As you know, that goodwill is a very, very pertinent issue in case of admission, retirement and death of partnership firm, or in any sale of partnership business. So goodwill, valuation of goodwill is a very, very pertinent issue in accounting, especially company accounting and partnership accounting. So now we have already taken up 3 classes on valuation of goodwill. As per the basis of valuation, pehla valuation hum log kiye as per the average profit in class number 1, that is episode 307, that is first class on valuation of goodwill, average profit. Next class was on I introduced the concept of average maintainable profit, and that is a very, very pertinent concept, and that was in class number 8308, and goodwill valuation 2, and third class was on valuation of goodwill on the basis of super profit method, and this is the fourth class where I would like to concentrate on the fourth, another method of valuation of goodwill, and that is capitalization of profit. So far we have, itna din se hum log kya kiye hain, hum log profit liye hain, koi ek saal ka profit nahi, koi saal ka profit, 5 saal, 6 saal, 7 saal, 2 saal, 10 saal, 8 saal, ha, to usko hum kya kiye, average kiye, average karne ke baad usko average profit to goodwill, as goodwill we cannot consider, so we have multiplied it by some purchase, by years purchase, 3 years purchase, 2 years purchase, 5 years purchase, like that. That was the 3 years or 4 years purchase of the average profit. Next, the concept was 2 or 3 or 4 years purchase of the average maintainable profit. Okay, average maintainable profit. In the third class, we have calculated goodwill on the basis of super profit, few years purchase of the super profit. Okay, and what is super profit? All have already been dealt in the class number 09. You must go through that duly for having a close contact with this class, for having understanding of this class. Now, friend, today we are considering the different ways, capitalization of profit. Capital, what is capitalization? So far we have valued goodwill, we have find out the value of goodwill on the basis of the profit, okay, on the basis of profit. And here in the process, capitalization of profit, capital, what is the concept of capitalization? Capitalization is the process, capital is the process of finding out the capital value of the business house or any organization at a given rate. At a given rate of interest, basically. So at a particular rate, her organization try to earn profit, and how they earn profit with the help of the assets and of course the liabilities which the business is having. Okay, then the total assets in one side, in the balance sheet, total assets in one side and the liabilities on the other side. Liabilities includes outsiders liabilities like syndicators, bank overdraft, bank loan, outstanding liabilities, and internal liabilities. Internal liabilities refers to the capital of the partners and reserves and surplus. Okay. Now the total assets minus liability, outsiders liability, represents the net assets, and this net assets is regarded as the basic capital of the organization. Now, when the organization is earning some better rate of profit, then they would try to find out what is the total value of the net assets. The net assets as represented in the balance sheet. Okay, this is one part. And the net asset as represented at the earning rate, there is a difference. The total value of net assets, which has been calculated with the help of the earning rate of interest, is the process of finding out the capital. That is the net capital, and from that capital, when we deduct the net assets as depicted, as shown by the balance sheet, that this difference is regarded as the value of goodwill. Okay, so now just I am repeating it. The organizations are having their assets and liability position. From this assets and liability position, considering the asset and outsider's liability, we find out the net assets. And the value of net assets is calculated on a particular date with the help of the earning rate. And when this amount, the profit, the profit is considered for calculation of the total value of the business with the help of the given rate of interest is the capital value we have found out. And from that capital value, when we deduct the net assets as shown in the balance sheet, the difference is the value of the goodwill. Clear? Now, how do we do that? What are the pertinent concept? There are two concepts, okay? Capitalization of average profit, okay? And capitalization of average profit. Capitalization is based on what? Mera paas 10 rupiya income hota hai, jab mera capital or net asset is 1000. और जब मेरा एक रुपया होता है तब नीट एसेट्स कितना होगा ओके और जब मेरा पकड़ लो जब मेरा 5000 हमारा अर्निंग होता है व्हाट विल बी द वैल्यू ऑफ नीट एसेट्स सॉरी व्हाट विल द वैल्यू ऑफ नीट एसेट्स इनटू 5000 ओके सो इट इज 50000 क्लियर सो इट इज द कैपिटल वैल्यू ऑफ द बिजनेस ओके सो एंड द फाइंडिंग आउट द वैल्यू of that organization, the capital value of that organization is the process of capitalization. So friends, हम लोग capital value कैसे निकालते हैं? Capital value के लिए हम लोगों को क्या चाहिए? हम लोगों का profit amount चाहिए, number one. Number two, rate of return चाहिए, normal rate of return, जो बाजार में होता है वही चाहिए. And और क्या चाहिए? और the net assets as shown in the balance sheet. So ये सब हमारा हाथ में information हो, तो हम इजीली फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ गुडविल ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ कैपिटलाइजेशन प्रोसेस. इन कैपिटलाइजेशन प्रोसेस वी मे सो फार एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू व्हाट आर द इंग्रेडिएंट्स नंबर वन प्रॉफिट एंड नंबर टू रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट. द आवर प्रॉफिट मे बी देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ प्रॉफिट वी हैव कंसिडर्ड इट इज एवरेज प्रॉफिट ओके एवरेज प्रॉफिट ऑफकोर्स एवरेज मेंटेनेबल प्रॉफिट ओके future maintainable profit, clear? Because from the total, from the profit given as per year, earned in different years, that profit should be adjusted. Some exceptional income may be incorporated therein, some exceptional losses may be incorporated therein, there may be some errors like overvaluation, undervaluation of closing stock, over and under valuation culture. These are some elements. Those have either inflated the profit or have deflated the profit. So necessary adjustments are to be made before getting the average profit. And when the profit given in our problem, okay, these and that and that and that problem, when we adjust the irregular events, irregular issues, take it into account, irregular issues which should not be regular and which should not happen normally. Then after the adjustments, we get the average, we get the profits of the different years, and the totally after adding this profit, we divide it by the number and we get the average future maintainable profit. So average future maintainable profit, we may consider for the purpose of capitalization, or with the for the purpose of capitalization, we may consider the super profit. Okay, clear? And now this super profit or average profit when capitalized, get the value of goodwill. How would you? I have taken up the example, the same example which we took up in our problem deliberation number 309. Dekho friends, so this is the balance sheet. Balance sheet includes goodwill and also the fictitious assets like profit and loss account. So we have to find out the net profit, net assets. How would I find out the net assets? I have already told you the net assets are found out from the total asset minus goodwill minus fictitious assets. So it is 350,000 minus 40 plus 20, so it is 290,000, and and the outsider's liability is 20,000. So it is how much the opening capital employed and opening net asset is this much. This I have calculated in my previous class, but I am taking up the data for the purpose of today's deliberation. Now consider the closing. In the case of closing, it is 4 lakh, and from 4 lakh we should deduct 40,000, which stands goodwill, so it is 60,000. From 60,000 we should deduct syndicators of 20,000. So closing capital is 340,000. 340,000 closing net assets or closing capital. Okay, and average we can get 305,000. Okay friends, so this is our first part of capital employed, which will be of great use today in our today's deliberation. Next, I have told you average profit or average maintainable trading profit. Average profit as shown over here, 70,000 minus 20,000, 60,000, 66,000 and 44,000. And considering all this, we have got the average maintainable trading future profit is 44,000. Now, what is super profit? Super profit we have calculated in our last class. Super profit is the average maintainable future profit minus normal return. Average maintainable future profit minus normal return. Average maintainable future profit, how much it is? It is 44,000. We have already calculated. And normal return, means average capital employed into normal rate of return. But average capital employed is how much? It is 3,05,000. And 3,05,000, 10% of 3,05,000 is how much? It is 30,000. It is 30,500. Okay. And so it is average maintainable future profit 44,000. And from that we have deducted normal return. Normal return we have calculated by multiplying average capital employed into the normal rate of return, and it is 30,500. So this difference is super profit. So friends, we have already got the information which is required for the process of capitalization. Okay, capitalization. Number one, average maintainable profit. Number two, super profit. Now, how do you find out the value of goodwill with the help of average maintainable trading, average profit or average maintainable future profit? What is the capitalized value of business? The capitalized value, you have to find out the capitalized value of the business. Okay. Capitalized value of the business, what does it mean? It is not the value which is recorded in the books. Okay, the figures of assets and liabilities shown in the book, it is as per book value. But considering your earning capacity, goodwill is always based on the earning capacity of the organization. Goodwill is always based on the earning capacity of the organization. Okay, now the balance sheet value, the book value may show something different, but your profit earning capacity may be different, okay, as per the normal rate. Now, the capital, you have to find out the capital value of the business. How do you find out the capital value? Capital value is average maintainable future profit divided by the normal rate of return. In our problem, normal rate of return is 10,000. So, in the market, all other business houses are earning in the business houses in the same trade, all are earning or around more or less 10% profit on the capital employed. So, but what I am earning, if my earning is equal to that, there is no goodwill. But if my earning is more than, sorry, if my value of asset is more than the other organization as per the rate, normal rate, then we have the goodwill. So, capital is value of the business is found out average maintainable future profit divided by normal rate of return. Average maintainable future profit is how much? Sorry, friend. Average maintainable future profit is how much? It is 44,000. Okay, which we have already calculated yesterday in our previous class. It is 44,000. Now, what is the normal return? Normal return is 10%. Okay. Now, what is the value of the business? The value of the business is 4,40,000. It is the value of the business. Clear? Now, so whenever at a market rate, consider it, friend, at a market rate of 10%, it is the normal rate of profit in the same trade. When it is 10%, what should be the asset value? You are earning 44,000. So, 44,000 whenever you are earning, at a 10% rate of profit, your asset value should be 4,40,000. Okay? This is the normal sequences. But what is your asset value? As shown in the balance sheet, your net assets, dekho. Net assets as per in your balance sheet shows that the closing net assets is 3,40,000. So closing net asset is 3,40,000, while as per your earning capacity, your capital should have been 4,40,000. So 4,40,000 is the capitalized value of your business. So your business house has book value of net asset is 3,40,000, but the original value should have been 4,40,000. So the difference between the capitalized value of the business minus net assets is the value of goodwill. Okay. So goodwill is calculated on the basis of capitalization process. Considering average profit, what we do? We take the average profit first, average future maintainable profit first, and that are capitalized with the market rate of interest. So average future maintainable trading profit, average future maintainable profit divided by the normal rate, we get the capitalized value of the business. What it should be? So it should be in our problem, it is 4,40,000. But what is the book value? So the difference between capitalized value of the business minus net assets, consider it. Capitalized value of the business as per your earning capacity. Your earning capacity is 44,000. As a market rate, your capital should be 10%. So 10% of it should be your capital, and 10% of this is 44,000. So it should be your capital, but books of accounts are showing that you are having the capital or net asset is 3,40,000. So this difference is the additional asset which you have in your organization, but it is not shown in the books of accounts, and that is your value of goodwill. Clear? So it is the value of goodwill, it is the process. And now if you can take it is the closing capital has been closing net assets has been considered as a net asset, because we should show that. But if we take the average asset, then it should be 4,40,000 minus 3,50,000. So it would be the value of goodwill. But friend, we do not take this one, okay, because our objective is valuation of goodwill at a particular event, and the event happens at a particular date. So the date is the closing date. So the closing net asset should be taken for the purpose of valuation of your goodwill. Now you see now your total net assets will be how much? Net assets will be 4,40,000, but it is 3,40,000. So difference is value of goodwill. Clear? So this is the capitalization of the average profit. Okay, next, capitalization of super profit, valuation of super profit. Valuation of super profit is done with the help of super profit divided by the normal rate of interest. What is the super profit? Super profit is 13,500. This divided by the normal rate of return. So it is the value of goodwill, 1,35,000. Okay. So this is the two basis of the method of capitalization, the method of capitalization of profit, okay, for valuation of goodwill. I am summing up with this. All these things have already been done in our previous classes. Super profit, capitalization. I'm summing up for 2 minutes. 2 minutes spent. What is capitalization process? Capitalization is the process of finding out the capital value of the business house at a particular date on the basis of the normal return. ठीक है? Then how would you find return? For the purpose of, we should consider profit. It may be super profit, it may be average maintainable profit. Whenever we are considering average maintainable profit, we find out the total value. With the help of capitalization of average profit, we find out the net value of net amount of capital. Okay, mind it. Whenever we are using the average maintainable future profit as the basis of capitalization method, used in the capitalization method, then what we find? We found the net capital value of the business. From that capital value, we deduct profit, we deduct the net assets, and we get the value of goodwill. But whenever we are considering super profit method, we have, in case of finding out super profit method, we have already deducted this amount, average capital into net normal rate of return. Okay, so we have already deducted. So we only taken up the cream of the profit, and that cream of the profit, that is the additional profit earned by the business house in the market. Okay, in comparison to other super profit, was the super profit. Super profit is the profit, is the that part of profit which is excess of normal profit. Okay, normal profit, and that super profit is only the whenever we are considering super profit as for the purpose of capitalization of business, then super profit divided by the normal rate of return. Our super profit is 13,500. At the rate of 10%, it is 1,35,000. Okay, so it is our super profit method, and it is our total profit method, average future maintainable profit. And if we consider the average capital employed, in that case the value of business on the basis of capitalization of average profit will be equal to the value of the amount of capitalization value on the basis of super profit. So if we take this figure in both cases, the more or less the value of goodwill will be the same. But we do not do that. We basically take the closing asset position for the valuation of goodwill. Okay, so it depends on the practice of the organization, but whatever may be the practice, this is the process. Okay, the process being the same. So friend, this is our fourth class on the valuation of goodwill. Okay, our next class will be some critical problem on a partnership accounting. Okay, so thank you very much, friend. Please go through the topic minutely. Any queries, go through. Please give your likes or dislike and make comments. Okay, thank you very much. Stay tuned with us and be safe.